Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to produce vertical video using iMovie on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 600 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So let's say you took some video with your iPhone, but instead of holding it horizontally when you shot the video, you held it vertically. Now you're stuck with vertical video. If you edit this video in iMovie, you can't edit it in vertical format. You have to edit it in horizontal format. But there is a way in iMovie to edit vertical video and produce a vertical video as a result. So here I am in iMovie, and if I go to create a new project, you'll see here there are two options, movie and trailer. There's actually a third option that we're going to see in a minute. If I choose a movie as I normally would, I get a normal movie here, and I could drag and drop into it some vertical video shot on the iPhone. So now you can see the vertical video here in a horizontal space. I've got black bars on the left and the right. And if I go to export it using File, Share, File, or any of these options, you can see I get black boxes on the left, black boxes on the right, and the entire video fits in the middle. Let's export this one. Now if we look at this video here, you can see I've got a horizontal video here with the vertical video embedded in the middle of it. Now you can, if you want, click on Crop here. Use Crop to Fill. Select an area of this vertical video to enlarge and fill the horizontal frame, and now you have horizontal video. But that won't always work because you're going to be cutting off lots of things at the top and bottom. So instead, let's create the project in a different way. Remember how I clicked Create New and you saw Movie and Trailer there? Well, there's a third option. If you go to the File menu, you'll see New Movie and New Trailer, but you also see New App Preview. Well, an app preview is something for app developers to be able to create previews for their iPhone apps, the ones that you see in the App Store when you go to look at apps and there's like a video preview of the app. This is one way to create those. But we can use it for regular videos as well. So I'll hit OK here and it looks like it creates a regular video project. But this is going to use vertical video. I still see a horizontal space here because this is how I have the parts of the window broken up. But if I drag that same video in here, you can see the vertical video there, and then I go to File, Share, File. You'll see here it looks a little bit different. It still gives me this square preview here with black bars on either side, but don't worry about that. Now you can choose resolution here, and this will give you the number of vertical pixels. I'll choose 1080p. I'll go to Next here, and I'll save this out. So now you can see I've got my first test here, which remember gives you a horizontal video with black bars on both sides. And now I have this vertical video here, which is a true vertical video. You can see there's no black bars. The actual size of the video is vertical. If I go to Window, Show Movie, Inspector, I can see here that it's 608 by 1080. So it's still using 1080 to represent the vertical number of lines. So it shrunk my movie down a bit. If instead I would have gone to Share, File, and then chosen 4K and exported that, then I get this video here. And if I do Window, Show Movie Inspector, you can see it's 1920 high. 4K would actually be 2160, but it's not going to go above the maximum resolution. So it's actually 1080 by 1920, the original resolution of this video that I shot. So that means I can go back in here and I get edited. I can trim the video. I can add in other video clips if I want. I can do all the different things I do in iMovie. And when I produce this, I'll get vertical video. I could even bring in some horizontal video here, and it's going to clip it to make it vertical video. So cropping out the left and right sides. The output's going to be vertical, so that's what I'm going to see represented here. Now I can also add things like titles and backgrounds and transitions, just like I could regularly in iMovie. But there's not going to be as many title choices because I'm stuck in this app preview theme. So a lot of these title choices have to do with actually making app previews. The same with backgrounds. But don't worry about that because you could always go back out to projects, go into any horizontal projects you want, add a title here. So for instance, I could use this title here. I can add it at the beginning. I could select it, copy it, go back to projects, go into my vertical video, my app preview, and I could place the cursor where I want and paste. And I'll paste in the title just as it was in the horizontal video. So you can use copy and paste if you need to get to a title or background that's not available in the app preview mode. Now as I mentioned earlier, this doesn't help you if you're going to be distributing your video in a place where horizontal video is expected. So playing it on a television set or uploading it to YouTube, for instance. But some places do accept vertical videos and videos of different dimensions. For instance, a lot of different social networks will do that. Or maybe you're just going to be sending this or sharing this as a file and you want somebody to just get that vertical video as a file and be able to view it just like this on their Mac or PC. That's why you might want to edit and produce a vertical video rather than squeezing a vertical video into a horizontal space. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.